Good evening and welcome to St. Laurence. Today we are celebrating the Feast of the Holy Family. Our presider today is Father Chung Sun, assisted by Deacon Ray. Please stand and let us join together in singing number 446, O Little Town of Bethlehem, number 446.
The Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Well, Merry Christmas, everyone.
Christmas.
And are you all ready for the new year?
Yes.
Drink some champagne? Some fireworks? No fireworks. We're starting fireworks tonight here, right? Yeah, spiritual fireworks, that is. Anyway, every time I love that song, every time I hear that song, I feel like I'm a little baby held by my mom drinking hot chocolate for some reason. Oh, little child of Bethlehem. I love that song. Brothers and sisters, it's good. It's good to be a child of God. It's good to have parents, families, and loved ones. This is what we celebrate today. The wonderful aspect of family life, the life-giving reflection of the Trinity that is life-giving. Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sin and so prepare ourselves for the sacred mystery.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the way to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
We give you thanks.
To give us the shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them, in part practicing the virtues of family life and in the bond of charity, and so in the joy of your house delight one day in eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Sirach. God sets a father in honor over his children. A mother's authority he confirms over her sons. Whoever honors his father atones for sins and preserves himself from them. When he prays, he is heard. He stores up riches who reveres his mother. Whoever honors his father is gladdened by children, and when he prays, is heard. Whoever reveres his father will live a long life. He who obeys his father brings comfort to his mother. My son, take care of your father when he is old. Grieve him not as long as he lives. Even if his mind fail, be considerate of him. Revile him not all the days of his life. Kindness to a father will not be forgotten. Firmly planted against the debt of your sins, a house raised in justice for you. The word of the Lord.
Our responsorial psalm today is taken from Psalm 128.
Thank you. rejoicing at your table. Blessed are those who love you, happy those who follow you, blessed are those who seek you, O God. May the blessings of God be yours all the days of your life. May the peace and the love of God live always in your heart. Blessed are those who love you, happy those who follow you, blessed are those who seek you, O God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another if one has a grievance against another. As the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these, put on love, that is, the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the days were completed for their purification according to the law of Moses, they took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. Just as it is written in the law of the Lord, every male that opens the womb shall be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer the sacrifice of a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons in accordance with the dictate in the law of the Lord. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, awaiting the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Christ of the Lord. He came in the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to perform the custom of the law in regard to him, he took him into his arms and blessed God, saying, "Now, Master, you may let your servant go in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you prepared in the sight of all the peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and glory for your people Israel." The child's father and mother were amazed at what was said about him. And Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be contradicted, and you yourself a sword will pierce, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed." There was also a prophetess, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years, having lived 7 years with her husband after her marriage, and then as a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshiped day, night and day with fasting and prayer. And coming forward at that very time, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were waiting the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
All right, my little friends. You know, was the gospel today about the 12th day of Christmas, two turtle dove and a partridge in a pear tree? Is that what it's about today? Yes or no? Yes or no, with my little friends? Yeah, I asked my little friends over there. My little friends, what do you think? Yes or no? No, it's not. It's not about that. But there was two pigeon involved in there. Was there a yes or no in the gospel today? Yes or no? Big brother, yes. Yes? Okay. You're right, there was, right? And really, what was the first reading? I gotta get my server now, might as well. I didn't get them earlier, so. What was the first reading? Who is it from? Does anyone, you guys were listening? Saint, there's only three. Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Oh, you remember, Luke now, I just gotta mention, it was Luke, very good. It was Luke. What about the first reading? You know who it's reading from? The book of who? It starts with an S. I was going to spell it, but then I don't know if I would spell it right. It was Sirach. Yes? Yes or no? Okay, yes, it was Sirach. What about the second reading? What is it on? Is it St. Paul? St. Paul to the Corinthians? Hey, you're right. But you're not a child back there. Remember that. All right. All right. Anyways, I'm going to get my friends over here real quick. Today is the whole purpose is, you know, obedience. But as Catholic, we know that logical obedience, right? Not just any form of obedience. It's about the blessings is worth it to be obedient. Do you listen to your mom and dad? Good. That's a blessing for you. Do you listen to your mom and dad? Can I get a goo goo gaga? Okay, there you go. Here you go, guys. It's two more. Okay. Yes, today we learned the goodness of obedience from all the readings today about the family life, right? The joy of it all. And when I speak today about family life, some of you might bring up some wounds. And all of us, is the Holy Family itself, did they have a perfect experience of the family, yes or no? Do you think they have a perfect experience? Everything was easy, smooth sailing for them? No, even they have struggles. They were literally persecuted, chased down for Jesus, out towards Egypt, you name it, they couldn't find a place. They were suffering a ton. There was no such thing as easy having family, but it's worth it. This is what it's today all about. It is worth having family and yes, I acknowledge those of you when I say family brings up wounds and scars, and I'm sorry you experienced abuse, hurt, or harm, or any form from your mother, your father, or even your children, you know? I'm sorry that you went through those things, but it's worth it. There's still room for healing, restoration with God's grace. It's worth it, my dear friend. Here's why. Look, because there's a fad or there's a movement around. It's called, what is it? Some of the young people know what this is. Young married people or young adults. It's called DINK. You guys know what that means? D-I-N-K. Double the interest, no kids. Double the interest, no kids. Live in a way that I got my income. We're going to live a luxury life, enjoy vacation, and do all these things. And we got no kids to worry about. And, you know, it's a social media thing. They only show you the good things. They never show you what's really going on when the cameras are not showing, right? When the cameras are not showing, everybody struggles. I guarantee you that from confession, okay? Everybody struggles. When the cameras are off, everybody struggles. Let me see. Let me tell you. So you're missing out, though, that, you know, those fads are just temporary. If you look what Jesus Christ and the Holy Family and the readings teaching you, the beauty of respecting your father and bearing, loving your mother, your wife, and guiding your kids. There's the reading that Sirach and St. Paul in Colossians is trying to show us, and Luke is trying to show us the Holy Family. Live that. There's a eternal and long endurance of happiness. Yes, there's a struggle. Because, you know, the facade don't tell you that people have God built man and woman with a certain function in their body to a certain age only. You can't have kids to another age, okay? Or that's most likely, unless you're Sarah and Abraham, and I know a few of those in our parish. There is. But I'm saying, though, your bodies aren't made to have kids. Eventually, you can't have kids. And there's a lot of buyer's regret that I should have had kids. I know a ton of those, more than the, you know, double the entrance and, you know, no kids. There's definitely a lot more buyer's regret for not having kids. Because why? Yes, having kids is a risk. Like you say, there's family issues. There's a risk. But you can always gain the material thing, the success, the vacation, those things later on. You can have those. But you can never, if you don't have kids when you can you have them later again? No. Why take that severity risk? There's a beauty and logical reason to having family. Because I, as a priest, I've seen, I'm not saying that anything bad with family, didn't have kids. Some of you guys are living wonderful, holy lives, and that you're called for that. And that's a true blessing. As priests, as sister, as single people that you're called for, that's a beautiful blessing. But I do see comparison to those in hospital in moments or when they're sick. And I was blessed to have a loving family. My mom and dad were not perfect in any ways. But at least I had them, and I appreciate that. And I see when they're sick, the joy of family gathering, the joy of them being able to be there, it way overcover the cost of not having kids and the short-term gain. There is such a beauty to what Sirach is teaching us. Sirach is all of the wisdom of what the Israelites were going through. When it means to listen to be obedient to the father and show your father reverence, is not that, you know, to completely, like I say, be obedient to the wrongful things too, but rather there's something there that's telling father, if he is showing sense of prayerfulness, of faith, growing the kids in your life, wife, be obedient to that. And if you hear this, always a lot of women that don't read the rest of the gospel or the rest of Ephesians, they miss out on that. They think like, oh, this is suppressive. No, you read the rest of Ephesians. Why? Because after that, it's calling men to be sacrificial to your wife and like Christ. And how did Christ sacrifice? To death for his church, for his bride. And that's what it's calling for, us to support the husband if he is a man of faith. And it's calling, challenging all of us fathers, men, to be growing deeper in our faith, to be that example so that women can feel trust and supported that this is a good man of God. And that obedience to having that faithfulness to God give us the strength as father and as husband to nurture our family. And women, as obedience to your husband and to God, give you that support you need and that security that you need within your family. And the same with children. Obedience to your parents will lead you to great success to the human relationship when you deal with manager bosses in the future. But if you don't have that now, respect for your elders, your parents, you're not going to have that in the work area, in the community life, and that good networking of people. That's just so important, to have good obedience in the scriptures there. And Mary and Joseph Lee, definitely, that's what the whole pointing of, you know, she didn't need to do the sacrifice. She was pure, right? She was virgin, right? Without sin. But she chose to do the cleansing, to do these ritual, to show the obedience of following what God established for the people. And to do the offerings of the two turtle doves, because they really didn't need that. But yet, Mary, obedience, Joseph. Now, Joseph is very wise. You know, a friend told me this story right here. He said a husband, his neighbor always, he always go to his neighbor. This man always go to his neighbor and say, you know, my wife and I, we're always fighting. There's always issue. How you guys do? And he's like, he's always telling him, so far, so good. And eventually he just gets frustrated at his neighbor and say, how come you never have any problem? Every time I ask you, what's going on? How are you? How do you guys do it? How is it that you say so far, so good all the time? And then he said, you didn't hear me right. He pointed to the sofa. He said, so far, so good. You say that, you know. He's saying, you know, that's husband life, married life, you know. You have to listen. And St. Joseph is very wise. He didn't complain. He didn't fight. You know, do you even hear St. Joseph talk in the gospel? No. He's a man of prayer. That's why Mary, you never say, Mary always do what St. Joseph, as Jesus, as God asked her, take the hand, and he also listened. He don't say anything. He trusts, he pray. And these are both logical reasoning and prayerful people. They didn't just do it out of blind obedience, but through discernment. Both Mary and Jesus were prayerful and discerning people, logical people. And he took his wife, he took Mary through many challenges and difficulties without complaint, without any of those angry at this, why me, why that, but faithfully doing these things in obedience to God and honoring God. And that's the gift that we will be blessed with, the family life. Yes, like I say, there is a risk, but everything is a risk. But family life is so worth it. And God is teaching us today, learning obedience and faithfulness to God, faithfulness to loving one another and caring for one another brings tremendous life and blessing in the long run. Amen. Let us stand, dear brothers and sisters, as we offer our prayers and we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered the death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We pray, dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate this holy family, to intercede and ask the Holy Family and God to bless us.
For the family of the church, that we may give respect and dignity to all God's children, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For leaders of nations, that during this holy season of peace, they will work to break down barriers that divide, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who struggle to keep their family together or to reestablish bonds with those who have been estranged, that the Holy Family may strengthen them in their efforts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For parents who have experienced the death of a child, that they will find healing and strength, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the sick, those listed in the Book of the Sick and their caregivers, that they will be comforted by the tender compassion of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who have died will rest securely in the eternal peace of God's kingdom, especially Jesus Guerra, husband of Carolina Guerra and father of Carlota, Julieta, and Sammy Guerra, Ann O'Shea, sister of Nora Mason, Bill Smith, husband of Leslie Smith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our own intentions, and the intentions of this Mass, for Jessica and Zach Peters, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. We pray for all those who suffer with cancer, chronic illness, mental and spiritual affliction, for their healing and their families. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
In the beauty of the family, for the respect for the dignity of life, in a special way, pray for those who are experiencing unplanned pregnancy. Let them know that their love, not judged and supported by your church and many organizations. Let them be protected, Lord, and from any coercion or pressure to take the life of their child. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
pray for all those who have lost their loved one in miscarriages. Especially pray for Tui, just lost her child today, asking for prayers. We pray for her and her family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Heavenly Father, watch over our families and bless us as you bless the Holy Family. Hear the prayers we make on behalf of all the families of the world and grant them through your Son, whose coming we continue to proclaim in joy and peace.
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation, humbly asking that through the intercession of the Virgin Mother of God and Saint Joseph, you may establish our families firmly in your grace and your peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For on the feast of this all-field mystery, though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours, and begotten before all ages, he has begun to exist in time, so that raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation, and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. The fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." My Lord, my God. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Lord my God. The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and Italo, his assistant bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostle, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit, let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Deacon. Thank you, Deacon. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receives it. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord. The body of Christ, keep me safe. Thank you.
As we come forward to receive the body and blood of Christ, let us join together in singing number 441, Silent Night, number 441.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Bring those you refresh with this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share their company forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
January 1st is the Solemnity of Mary, Mother of God. Because it falls on a Monday, though, it is not a holy day of obligation this year. However, for those of you who wish to attend, Mass is at 7:30 a.m. and noon, both in the church. If you'd like to start the new year in a new way, join Father Jason here in the church at 11 p.m. on New Year's Eve for Adoration and Midnight Mass. If you've been away from the Catholic Church and desire to reconnect, join Deacon Tom for Remembering Church. A new group starts this Wednesday at 7 p.m. Register now for Heart of Worship and save $20 if you sign up before January 23rd. It's Saturday, February 10th, with great speakers, dinner, Mass, and adoration. Details are in the bulletin and on the parish website. And lastly, Happy New Year, everyone.
Happy New Year. Just a quick saying, it's always so beautiful at our parish. You guys agree?
Yes.
Yeah, I just want to make a quick thank you for all those who contribute and help in the decorating and of course getting the flowers for us. In a special way for Gretchen and Catherine and I'm in trouble now. For Gretchen and Gail, pray for them because throughout the years they keep all the flowers fresh. They get their team and they deck out this place and the St. Joseph men as well. So thankful for them and be praying for them as well, please. And and for all my young friends, the last week of January, which is actually the concluding of Christmas, the one of the old calendars, is when I'm gonna give out all my gifts to those that collect the most, at least a minimum of 20, okay? So if you've been collecting, you should probably have been sitting at the front. You should be having more than 20 by now. So there'll be a prize, at least a complimentary prize if you collect 20. But if you have the most, I have $100 for you, the most, for a main event. And second prize and third prize, it will be another prize too. So get ready. All my little friends, you've been collecting and sitting at the front, you should have plenty of cards, okay?
100 US dollars or Vietnam?
Filipino. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
As we go forth, let us join together in singing number 430, Angels We Have Heard on High, number 430.